गुड आफ्टरनून। हाँ हेलो, माय वॉइस इज ऑडिबल? हाँ, ओके, थैंक यू निकिता। व्हाट अबाउट द रिमेनिंग स्टूडेंट? ओनली 10 स्टूडेंट्स आर जॉइन द मीटिंग। We'll wait for 2 minutes, then we'll start with a new bit from the chapter number 4, chemical and photochemical energy based machining process. Screen is visible. Whether screen is visible to all? Okay, thank you. Now, in today's lecture, we are starting with the new point of this fourth chapter, that is the chemical machining. Write down name of the process, that is the chemical machining process. In short, it is represented by capital C, small h, capital M, CHM. CH for chemical, M for machining. This chemical machining process, it is used from olden days in order to engrave the metal in a desired shape. So from ancient days, this process is used by the human being. This chemical machining process that was used to remove the material from the metal by the dissolution in a controlled manner from the workpiece by the application of certain elements, it will be called as the maskant, and another element it will be called as the etchant. So these are the two important elements, those are considered during the chemical machining process. First one, that is the maskant, and second one, that is the etcher. Now, what is this maskant? Maskant, it is used, it will do not allow the etchant to penetrate and react with the workpiece to dissolve it. Means whenever you have to carry out the chemical machining process, at that time you have to provide a maskant. Maskant is one kind of a insulating material. It will be made up from synthetic resin or rubber, right? And it does not allow to react the chemical, that is the etchant, that was the alkaline based solution, right? It does not allow to make a contact between etchant and the workpiece, which is made up from the metal. So maskant, it does not allow etchant to penetrate and react with the workpiece in order to dissolve it, so that chemical dissolution is to be carried out in order to remove the material from that workpiece. So simply you think that maskant is the one kind of insulating element that avoid the reaction between etchant and the workpiece. Now what is the etchant? It will dissolve the workpiece and remove the material by chemical action. that each and are the chemical solution. Those are alkaline base. They react with the material of the workpiece, and by chemical reaction, that will be called as a chemical dissolution. The precipitation, it will be formed in the form of the slurry or sludge, and material is to be removed from the workpiece. So by using this agent, we can dissolve the material of the workpiece and we can remove the material by chemical reaction. So write down this introduction, mainly write down how this chemical machining process is to be carried out, why it will be used, and what is the maskant and agent. Write down what is the maskant and what is the agent. No one is in waiting list. Everybody have joined the lecture. Okay, now this diagram, it shows the setup of a chemical machining process, right? So this will be a container or tank. It is filled with the agent. So this will be the agent container, we may call it as agent container. It is filled with the agent. Agent, this is the agent, blue color, and this line, it will be called as black color line, agent resistance lining, and this will be our workpiece, and we have to engrave the shape B on that workpiece. Means B shape, it will be the area to be machined, and overall this rectangle shape, it will be the workpiece, and this hatching line, it will be shows that it is enclosed with the maskant, and this blue dot line, these are nothing but the agent solution. Also, this agent container, it is provided with the heating coil. This dark circle, large circle, it will show the heater coil, and there will be a agitator to sterilize the solution, right? And this will be a certain control system by which we can immerse this workpiece in this agent solution for the proper time, for a particular period, so that chemical reaction it will be takes place with this etchant, with this open part, that is a B shape. या पार्ट से इचेंट केमिकल रिएक्शन होना बाकी मेटल का पार्ट हा का हा एचिंग लाइन जो दाखिल है मास्क एंड अप्लाय के सो दैट पार्ट डज नॉट एक्सपोज विथ द इचेंट ओनली दिस बी शेप पार्ट इट विल बी एक्सपोज विथ इचेंट इचेंट डज द केमिकल रिएक्शन ऑफ द मटेरियल ऑफ दिस वर्क पीस विच इज प्रेजेंट इन शेप बी and engrave the material in the form of this B letter shape. After that, we can remove this workpiece from this etchant container, then remove this maskant and clean the workpiece so that we are getting engrave of the material in shape of letter B on this work. In order to maintain a constant rate of removal or good material removal rate by using the electrochemical machining process, we have to maintain certain temperature of this etchant and proper concentration of etchant throughout this container, etchant container. So this will be the experimental setup and working of this chemical milling or chemical machining setup. So draw this diagram, setup for chemical machining, name each part and try to understand working of each part. Each end is a chemical solution that will react with a workpiece in order to remove the material from that workpiece by chemical action. The material which is to be removed, it will only expose to the etchant another part of that portion of that workpiece. It will be covered with a maskant in order to avoid the reaction of etchant with another part of the workpiece. So this will about the setup for chemical machining. Draw this diagram. Okay, now how this chemical machining is to be carried out. The stepwise procedure it is given on this slide. The first step is to clean the workpiece by using alkaline solution, and then it will wash with the fresh water. Whatever the workpiece you have chosen for the chemical machining, first you have to clean this workpiece first by using alkaline solution and then by fresh water. The second step of the chemical machining is to provide the coating of the maskant over this workpiece. There are different methods by which we can provide the maskant over this workpiece. First one, that is the cut and peel method. Second one, that is the screen method. And third one, that is the photoresist method. Out of these three method, we can choose any one of the method in order to apply the maskant coat over that workpiece. This maskant, it will protect the workpiece surface from the chemical reaction. Means this maskant, it will act as a one kind of insulator that does not allow to carry out any chemical reaction with the etchant and the work. Third step, that is after applying the maskant over the workpiece, that workpiece is deep in a etchant bath for a desired duration of the time. You have to dip that workpiece in a etchant container for a particular set of time. After that, you have to take out the workpiece from the etchant bath and you have to remove the maskant layer. And after which you have to wash out this workpiece thoroughly under the fresh water. This is the steps we are using in a chemical machining process. First step, you have to clean the workpiece by alkaline solution, then fresh water, then apply the maskant by any of three methods, cut and peel method, screen method, or photoresist method. Then third step is you have to dip this workpiece, which is applied with the maskant, in a etchant container for a particular time, a particular duration of the time. After that time, you have to remove or take out the workpiece from that etchant bath and remove the maskant layer from the work. When you have removed the maskant layer from the workpiece, then you have to wash out this workpiece thoroughly by using the fresh water. Read the steps of chemical machining. Next, we may carry out this cleaning process manually, or we may use chemical cleaning. Why we go for the chemical cleaning process? Because chemical process, it will ensure proper adhesion of a masking material to the workpiece. Means manually, when you are applying the maskant on the workpiece, there will be a possibility of a not having a proper adhesion of the maskant with the workpiece. That possibility is a quite less proper adhesion. So proper adhesion, it will be ensured by using this chemical cleaning process. Also, in case of debonding of muscle, stray itching it will occur. Since repetitively applying the muscle, at that time stray itching it will get occur. The different type of the cleaning that was depend on kind of muscle, kind of the material of the workpiece, and how much machine depth it will be required. Based on that, we can choose any type of the cleaning process. That is the vapor degreasing or alkaline etching. Cleaning of the workpiece which is having a porosity, that will be quite difficult. Also, to avoid the uneven material removal from the workpiece, you always supply the fresh etchant to the etchant tank. Also, in order to increase the material removal rate by this chemical machining process, the etchant, it is provided with some amount of heat by using the heating coil, and also it is provided with the agitator in order to proper mixing of the etchant. So the material removal rate, it will be enhanced in case of a chemical machining by providing agitation and heating of the etchant. In order to increase the strength of the etchant, we have to maintain proper filtration of the etchant after use and addition of the new chemicals, and we may add certain amount of the fresh etchant in a used etchant up to a certain percentage. By which method? By this method, we can add the strength of the etchant. The strength of the etchant, it will be maintained by proper filtration, by adding new chemicals, by replacing certain percentage of used etchant by the fresh one. This will be regarding the chemical machining, some steps in a chemical machining. Now, when we are dealing with the material removal, then there are two terms you must be think about: the carried out the rate of material removal. First one, that is the depth of cut. It also called as a machine depth. It will be a consider vertically downward, right? And undercut, that was the another term. It will be related with the material removal. So it will be considered laterally or linearly. This depth of cut, it will be a vertically, and undercut, it will be laterally or linear. Then how will you calculate the amount of undercut is to be? The amount of undercut, it will be depend upon the depth of cut. How much depth of cut it will be provided for the workpiece, which type of the etchant you are using, what will be the concentration or strength of that etchant, and mainly which material is to be used for the workpiece. Based on these parameters, we can calculate the extent of undercut, and this undercut can be calculated or quantified by formula. Each factor, ETCH, each factor, and this each factor is equal to U by D, right? What is the U? U for undercut and D for depth of cut. So machine depth and extent of undercut, it will be mainly calculated by using this each factor, and it will be controlled by using the time of immersion. Means for which particular time the material or workpiece is to be immersed in a each and container, that will be responsible to calculate the undercut, right? And whenever you have to get non-uniform machining, then there will be possibility of producing gas bubble, and that gas bubble it will be gets trapped. Because of that, non-uniform machining is to be carried out. So to avoid the non-uniform machining, whatever the gas bubbles they are produced during the chemical machining, they should not be get trapped. They should not be allowed to get stopped. Then and then only we can successfully carry out uniform machining by using chemical machining. After etching, right, means when you are removing the workpiece from the etchant container after the chemical reaction, you must have to clean that workpiece. And the cleaning of the workpiece, it will be carried out manually, that is mechanically or chemically. If parts are thick in size and more durable, maskant is to be applied. At that time, you go for the mechanically cleaning. If the maskant is a thinner and sophisticated part is to be clean, at that time you go for the chemical cleaning process. So these are the certain steps, those are used in a chemical machining process. Have you understood? Material removal, how it will be occurred. Chemical cleaning, how it will be carried out. These are the certain steps. Then chemical cleaning, material removal. Now observe this diagram. This is the first step. This is the workpiece. It is applied with the maskant. Second number step, we have to remove this material. So remove the maskant from that particular. Also, we can apply the maskant over here and remove the maskant in this proper shape. So each of the surface it will be observed like this. And whenever you are removing the material, the complete engraving of the part, it will be observed by this fourth step. What we studied in last material removal occur slide, that is the quantification of undercut. It will be calculated by the each factor, and each factor is the ratio of undercut to the depth of cut. If you are observing this diagram, so undercut from this initial to this final stage, it will be called as undercut. Scribed edge, and it will be the depth of cut. Upper portion of the workpiece to the depth of this cut. So this height, it will be called as the depth of cut, and this laterally distance, it will be called as the undercut. Draw this figure. Chemical machining, undercut, and machinery depth during. Is it over? Now there are certain process parameters. Those are affecting the material removal rate in terms of in case of the electrochemical machine. The first type of the parameter, that is the which type of the etchant you are using. There are different type of the etchants we are using for the machining of the different type of the metals and its alloys. So which type of the etchant you are selecting, it also affects the material removal rate. Second parameter, that is the temperature of the etchant. You have to maintain certain proper temperature of the etchant that will be responsible to increase the material removal rate. Then there are different type of the maskant. They are used in the by considering the different type of the etchant. So type of the maskant can also affect the material removal rate in case of a chemical machine. Which type of the method you are using for applying the maskant on a workpiece, and which is the method by which we can circulate the etchant in etchant tank, that is also have a effect on a material removal rate of the chemical machine. By using this chemical machining process, we can easily achieve the surface finish within a range of 0.75 to 3.75 micron. So these are the different types of the process parameters. Those are affecting the performance of chemical machining. Write down process parameters, type of etchant, temperature of etchant, type of maskant, method of applying maskant, method of circulating the etchant, and the surface finish which will be obtained by chemical machining process. It is in a range of 0.75 to 3.75 micron. Now next point, it is related with the method of applying the mask. So there are three methods by which we can apply the maskant over the workpiece. First one, that is the cut and peel method. Second one, that is the screen printing. Third one, that is the photoresistant mask. The first method, that is the cut and peel method, where we are using the maskant, it will be a neoprene, butyl, vinyl based material. Whenever you are applying the maskant, it will be applied by any of one of the method, by dipping, spraying or flow coating. The thickness of such kind of the maskant, it will be vary from 25 to 130 micron. During this cut and peel method, first you have to apply the maskant overall on entire surface of the workpiece. Then you have to cut and peel off from the area to be exposed to the etchant for the machining. That is, initially you have to apply the maskant on overall entire surface of the workpiece. After that, you have to cut the maskant as per the shape which will be required for engraving. Accordingly, that shape it will be peeled out from that workpiece, and that will be exposed to the machining by using the etchant. Scraping and peeling of the maskant, it will be done by using hand templates. These templates are used to cut the maskant as per the desired shape. The accuracy obtained by using such kind of cut and peel method of applying the maskant, it will be in a range of 130 micron to 750 micron, and that will depend on a size and type of the component which is used for the machining. or which will be being produced by using this chemical machining in case of a cut and fill method. So this is the first method of applying the maskant, that is the cut and fill method. Read the information regarding this method. Write down your roll number in chat box for the attendance. Hello. Okay. Go on. Second, okay, this will be the diagram that will be shows cut and fill up method that will be used for applying the maskant in chemical machining. Maskant coated area that will be marked, and maskant fill up from the marked area for each end reaction. This will be the total workpiece applied with the maskant. In this letter A, that was the area we have to fill out from that maskant. So this area, it will be exposed to the etchant for the chemical reaction. The remaining area that was shown by HL line, that will be a presence of the maskant on a workpiece, and that will avoid the chemical reaction of etchant with the workpiece. Only this portion of the maskant, which is we have to fill out, fill off, that will only expose to the etchant for chemical reaction. Same it will be shown in this figure, cut and fill. It will be applied with the maskant on an entire surface, then fill out B shape letter. Inside you, it will be shown by the maskant. The area it will be exposed to the etchant, it will be shown here. Black, it will be shown the maskant. इथून इथपर्यंत maskant आहे पुन्हा इथून हा एक्सपोज होतोय पार्ट etchantला, तो मटेरियल इज टू बी रिमूव्ह ओवर हिअर. इथं पुन्हा maskant आहे, इथून हा ब्लॅक maskant, इथं पुन्हा एक्सपोज होतोय, इथं पुन्हा maskant आहे. So this diagram is clearly indicating how this cut and fill method it will be used. Then screen printing is another method by which we can apply the maskant on a workpiece. It will be used for high volume production with a low accuracy and less etching depth up to a 1.5 mm, and for the small parts which are having a dimension of 1.2 meter length by the 1.2 meter width. Generally, screen printing type of the maskant method is used in a stainless steel machining of the stainless steel. Also, press the screen against the surface of the part and roll up the maskant. It will be mainly used for the stainless steel screening purpose. First of all, you have to screen the block of area which is to be etched. Then you have to press the screen against that surface of the part. After that, you have to roll up the maskant over that workpiece. Then you have to remove the screen and dry the part by baking on it. expression. So it will about the screen printing. Third one, that is the photoresist masker. It will be shown by flow chart. First you have to carry out the CAD processing drawing, then you have to carry out photo tool creation. If by using the software we can carry out these activities, then you have to carry out metal cleaning or surface workpiece cleaning process. Then you have to apply the photoresist coating on a workpiece. After that, whatever the drawing which will be created by using the CAD process, using a photo tool creation, you have to apply on this photoresist coating. So next part, it is the processing of a photoresist. For that purpose, you have to expose that workpiece to the ultraviolet ray, which will develop dry, pre-baking and post-baking is to be carried out. After that, etching stage is to be come into action. After etching the process, stripping of a photoresist, it will be carried out. And finally, after stripping of the photoresist part, we are getting the final product by using photoresist mask and process. So this is the third method by which we can apply the mask and over the workplace. Now, which are the mask and we are using? These are the material, work material, aluminium, aluminium alloy, iron base alloy, nickel, magnesium. So it is a used for limited type of the material, which chemical machining. If you are carried out chemical machining of aluminium and its alloys, then you use the maskant, which will be a polymer, butyl rubber, or neoprene. Likewise, iron base, nickel, magnesium, copper, titanium, silicon. It is a polymer that will be used as a material for the maskant. But while selecting the maskant, the maskant must have desired certain properties. That is, it should not be resistant to the etchant. It must be resistant to the etchant. It should be easily removable after machining over time or machining is over. It should not have any chemical reaction or effect on the workpiece. It should be stable at a high temperature of the each end part. So these are the some of the desirable properties of the mask. And this table shows material used for the mask or specific material of the workpiece. Read this slide, choice of the mask. Now, etchant is a chemical solution. It dissolves the metal by changing it into a metallic salt that goes into the solution. There are different type of the etchant, like iron chloride. It will be used for aluminium, copper, nickel, and their alloys. Ferrous nitrate. Likewise, there are different etchants. Those are used for a different kind of the material. Other etchant used are chromic acid and ammonium persulfate is also used as an etchant. Whenever you are selecting a particular etchant for the particular material by using the chemical machining process, there are certain factors you must have to consider, like a surface finish, material remove rate, depth of the penetration, material or type of the workpiece, likewise type of the mask and damage to the workpiece by each end, then availability of the each end, and overall cost of the process. It must be considered while selecting the each end in order to carry out chemical machining of a specific work with material. So this is all about the Yichen. And this table, it will show the maskant and Yichen. Those are required for different work with material with a certain characteristics. First, I will only describe. If you have to carry out the chemical machining of the aluminium, you may use the Yichen, that the Fe, iron chloride, and sodium hydroxide. For that purpose, we may use the maskant polymer. If you are using Yichen for machining of aluminium, the Yichen rate, it will be a 0.013 to 0.025. If you are using NaOH as a Yichen for machining of aluminium by using polymer as a maskant, then Yichen rate, it will be a in a range of 0.020 to 0.030. And for both the Yichen and maskant, in order to carry out the machining of the aluminium, the Yichen factor, it will be vary in a range of 1.5 to 2. So likewise, another workpiece material is there. For each workpiece material, there will be a separate type of the Yichen and a maskant also, and it will give the different Yichen rate and Yichen factor. Read the or make the point, note down the workpiece and Yichen and maskant material values in the table. Note down. Okay, next. In this slide, we will discuss about the advantages and limitations or disadvantages of the chemical machining process. The advantage, first advantage, it will remove the material uniformly, because each part which is exposed to the Yichen, that will be exposed in uniform manner, so that material is to be removed in a form. By using this chemical machining process, it is possible to make tapered sheets and structural members with the close tolerances and a better surface finish. So tapered sheet and structural members or different kind of the structures can be easily machined with a below the tolerance limit up to point plus or minus 0.2 to 0.3. That will be the close tolerance. It will be achieved by using the chemical machining with the surface finish in a range of what we say. It will be given in a last slide. That is the 0.75 to 0.75 to 3.75 microns. That much surface finish is to be obtained by using this chemical machining. Also, for carrying out the chemical machining process, we does not require highly skilled manpower. So semi-skilled or operators can be easily carried out certain kind of the chemical machine. These are the certain advantages. Now we will discuss about the limitations of this chemical machining process. The first limitation, that only few metals can be machined by using this chemical machining process. Second, whenever gases are to be formed during the chemical reaction, that evolve gases, when it will be collected under the mass gun, so it will result in a non-uniform machining of the workpiece. Because of that, it also affects the material removal rate, which will be become slow. Whatever the chemicals, those are used during this chemical machining, they may be in corrosive in nature. Also, certain chemicals have a property of a toxicity. So it will be harmful for the human being which will handling certain kind of the machining process. In case of the chemical machining, which will be carried out for certain kind of the alloys, it will give the different kind of the machining rate, and that will affect the surface finish quality of the workpiece. Means, if you are using chemical machining of different alloys, it will give the different machining rate or metal removing rate, and it will hampering the quality of the machining. So these are the certain disadvantages or limitations of the chemical machining. The last point, it will focus on application of the chemical machining process. The chemical machining process, it will be used to produce the any kind of the complicated shape in a delicate or fragile part. Certain aviation industries, where in order to produce the wing panels, we may use the chemical machining process. Whenever you have to manufacture the very thin lamination without burr, we go for the chemical machining. Certain jewelries, turbine engine rings, pressure vessel, bulkhead, PCB, that is a printed circuit board, and some of the sheet metal components, those are not be manufactured by welding and riveting, can be easily manufactured by using chemical machining. Specific application of this chemical machining, that is the chemical milling and chemical blanking. In chemical milling process, material is to be removed to produce the blends in order to reduce the weight of the component. Blends details, that is nothing but certain pockets and channels you have to produce on a workpiece. That will be used to reduce the weight of the workpiece. In case of a chemical blanking, that was used for produce the cavities, thorough cavities, means throughout the hole and slots you have to produce. And it also used for blanking complete parts from sheet by chemical etching periphery of the desired shape. means chemical machining is a specific application. It is related with the chemical milling and chemical blanking, and there are certain areas where it will be used widely, like aviation, printed circuit board, jewelry, pressure vessel, bulkhead, etc. So it's all about the applications of the chemical machining. With this, in today's lecture, we have completed the chemical machining part of the fourth chapter. Now only photochemical machining part is remaining from this chapter. So that part we have discussed. We will discuss in next lecture. If you have any doubt related to this point, that is a chemical machining, please ask me. A problem hai kya madhe? Then we will stop over here. Thank you. Thank you very much. We will stop over here.